the starting grid. Torrente on pole with the inside lane advantage. Anderson charging up from fourth, then Schiap and Morin. Stark in seventh after his qualifying incident. Marshalek ninth. Celio down in 10th with ground to cover to reach the upper ranks. Portuguese driver Benavente in 13th and Alberto Comparato in 19th. The final seconds as the crowds and drivers hold their breath for the first race of the season. The final seconds, the race is on. 19 boats launch off the pontoon and into that crucial starting straightaway to the commitment buoy. Good start from Torrente, also a great start for Alhamely and Robar as Philip Roms falls back between the two. Anderson keeping up with the Team Abu Dhabi boats while Stromoy drops back, struggling in their spray. Peter Morin finds himself getting squeezed back by Sami Celio, Morin struggling to keep up. Looking back from Schiap's on board, Celio then gets pushed back by Carella on the outside, then they both get squeezed out by Alhamely who surges ahead, leaving them in the spray. The Team Abu Dhabi boats firmly in the lead with Jonas Andersson giving chase. Look at Alberto Comparato in his first UIM F1H2O race coming up from last place to zoom up past Celio and then Carella. Comparato is on a rampage. He continues to rise up the field, overhauling Cedric Degouin and pulling up alongside Eric Stark, the Italian rookie, 8 spots from 19th place. Peter Morin chases Ahmed Alhamely, who's had a brilliant start, moving up from 17th to 7th, going head-to-head with Cantando in 6th. Out in the lead, Torrente going strong, but being chased hard by his teammate Alkamzi. Anderson in 3rd, with Maurits Stromoy holding on to 4th, but with the pressure of Philip Schiap on her outside. Francesco Cantando in the yellow Blaze performance boat, feeling the pressure from Ahmed Alhamely. It's been a dismal start for Carella and Celio, the pair languishing in 13th and 14th positions respectively, chased by Cedric Degouin of Maverick F1. As the leading triumvirate opened their lead over the rest of the field, Stromoy in 4th feeling the pressure from both Schiap and Cantando. Can the Norwegian hold point? Despite falling back at the start, Peter Morin climbs his way back to pass Alhamely on the port side to reclaim 6th position. Into the second lap, Maurits Stromoy goes a little wide on that turn, and Schiap senses his chance. He cuts in on the inside and snatches 4th place from the Norwegian. A gutsy and well-executed move from the Frenchman and 3-time world champion. Sean Torrente extending his lead in this opening Grand Prix of 2019. He wants to start his world title defense with a win here in Portimao. Eric Stark, who dropped 2 spots at the start, now working his way back up as he zips past Alhamely, the Emirati victory driver bumped down to 9th. Behind them, Polish driver Bartek Marszalek coming up fast from the rear. Marszalek has the speed and the Emirates racing driver also passes Alhamely, who finds himself sinking further back to 10th. Eric Eden of Team Amaravati, who had dropped 2 spots at the start, is chasing Alberto Comparato, who is having an excellent start to his first race, showing no signs of nerves. Comparato has left 2 multiple world champions behind as he's chased by Carella and then Philip Roms, Greg Foster and Sami Celio. Torrente opens a 3.85 second lead over Alkamzi, with Anderson another 3 seconds back from Alkamzi, then Schiap in 4th, Stromoy 5th and Peter Morin 6th, Stark back up in 7th ahead of Marszalek. Tough luck for Francesco Cantando, electrical problems forcing the Italian 12-time Grand Prix winner out in lap 6. Meanwhile, the battle heats up for 3rd position as Philip Schiap pushes on Jonas Anderson, seeing if he can find a way around the Swedish 5-time Grand Prix winner, but Anderson fends off the Schiap challenge. Eric Eden's pace and persistence pays off in lap 11 as he finally gets past Ahmed Alhamely, the victory driver finding himself back down in 10th as Eric Eden finds a space on the outside. More drama in the top 5 as Stromoy now finds Peter Morin working his way up beside her. Morin fast on the outside, but Stromoy shuts him out in the turn. Another disappointing end for Carella, who yet again fails to finish a race, this time his campaign dashed by a hole in his left sponson. Also out of the race is the sole remaining Blaze Performance boat, Greg Foster retiring with engine issues as the field narrows further by lap 18. The string of breakdowns continues. This time it's Eric Eden who's unable to continue. Tough break for the Swede, who was having a good run out there. Daniel Camsey is closing that gap with race leader Torrente moving hard on his teammate. Torrente feeling the pressure from last year's world number three, trying to hold off his rival and teammate. Further back, Peter Marin continues to put pressure on Moritz Stromøy. The Frenchman is neck and neck with the Norwegian, but Stromøy holds on, again using that inside advantage, but Marin not letting up on her starboard. Marin pushes hard, gets some air, and that slows him a bit as Stromøy holds point in fifth, and Marin loses momentum. But just as Marin was focused on passing Stromøy, Eric Stark zooms up past him as if out of nowhere as a Maverick F1 racer moves up in sixth, bumping Marin down to seventh. With the race passing the halfway mark, Al-Khamzi continues to close that gap with Torrente to just 1.65 seconds. Now Stark threatening the top five, and he's the one chasing his former teammate and fellow Scandinavian, Moritz Stromøy. But Stromøy has momentum of her own as she overhauls Philip Schiap, who appears to be slowing. Schiap is out of the race. This time, it's a fuel injector issue as a string of bad luck continues from last year. With Schiap out, Marin represents CTIC F1 Shenzhen China now as he continues to put pressure on Eric Stark, looking to regain the position he lost to the Swedish world number two a few laps back. Marin has excellent speed. He does it, gets past Stark on the outside there, moves up a position into fifth. Stark's woes continue as Bartek Marszalek then also passes him, the Polish driver bumping the Swede down another spot as he moves up to sixth. On lap 32, another boat is out. It's Philip Roms. In a battle for ninth position, Sami Celio trying to find a way around the young upstart Alberto Comparato, who's proving he has more than what it takes to race in the premier powerboating division. Comparato is ahead of his teammate Duarte Benavente, who struggles to find momentum but hangs on in the race, hoping to at least be in the points with a top 10 finish. With just 10 laps left, Tani Al-Khamzi is putting the pressure on Torrente, whose lead is cut down to just half a second as the two Abu Dhabi boats continue to stand head and shoulders above the field in their battle for the Grand Prix of Portugal title here. Meanwhile, further back, Peter Marin's rise continues as he finally catches Moritz Stromøy and passes the Norwegian. Marin is in fourth now. With the race entering the final stages, it's an intense battle unfolding with just over 5 seconds separating the top six boats, and it feels like the race could be anybody's for the taking. Stromøy does not give in. She's keeping Marin in her sights, and behind her is her teammate Bartek Marszalek in sixth. Excellent performance from Emirates Racing Team with just 6 laps remaining. It's been a very solid race for Team Amaravati veteran Jonas Andersson, who finished on the podium in the last race of 2018, and he wants to keep the string of good results going into 2019. Up in the fight for the lead, Al-Khamzi is now just a boat's length behind his teammate Torrente. As the battle heats up with a handful of laps remaining, the defending world champion trying to hold Al-Khamzi off, but Al-Khamzi going hard and strong. With no flags seen all race, this has really turned into a nail-biter with all drivers out there laying it all on the line. This is where experience, stamina, nerves, and grit play a huge role. This race is showing that we are in for a season-long inter-team rivalry to savor as Al-Khamzi and Torrente lock horns in what has been a thrilling first encounter of the year. But the laps run out, and Torrente hangs on to defend his Grand Prix title in Portimao. Sean Torrente is the 2019 Grand Prix of Portugal champion. Daniel Camsey once again runner-up. Andersson ends a fantastic race in third, with Peter Marin just behind him in fourth, and Stromøy bringing it home in fifth. Sean Torrente in a start-to-finish win, using his pole position advantage well, but it was not easy, feeling the pressure all race long from Al-Khamzi. In the end, just a second and a half was in it between Torrente and Al-Khamzi. Andersson never let up after seizing third from Stromøy at the start. Marin continued his fine form and consistency to finish fourth. Despite having some rough patches, Al-Hamli should still be happy with seventh. What a result for newcomer Comparato with 3 points from his first ever race, beating such names as Stark, Celio and Carella. Benavente just missing out on points in 11th. De Guin brings his boat in 12th. Team Abu Dhabi pick up where they left off, leading the world team standings with that 1-2 finish. Amaravati in second, and Emirates Racing a well-deserved third to start the year ahead of CTIC F1 Shenzhen China fourth, Victory fifth, and F1 Atlantic sixth, then Maverick, Sharjah Team, and Blaze Performance.
it was a tough race because the people behind, like Philippe Schaap, Maureen, Marit, everybody is so fast. So it was really, really demanding work this today to finish the race in the podium, because to close them behind, and then I push and get that small gap, and then I was too close to Tani, and no, it was incredible race.
Yeah, I was happy today for my boat is running very good in the rough water and windy condition. My team is working very hard for get this boat ready, and I push hard for my teammate Sean. Almost I catch him, but I'm happy today for finish second.
Great start to the year for Torrente, 20 points in his title defense, and it's already promising to be a very close fought UIM F1H2O season ahead.
I guess the first 20 laps, the boat was working amazing. I was lapping boats. I built up a 7-second lead, and I was kind of just pacing. I had a good pace going. And then I go down to the bridge corner, and I hit the down. I fly past the corner, and I'm like, what happened there? And then I start looking at the data, and I realize the trim isn't working all the time. I was able to hang on, and Tani knew I was wounded because our team knew I was wounded, and he was coming. And I was just doing everything I could just to hang on to the damn thing and get it to the end. And thankfully, I did, and we finished 1-2, and man, it's like a dream come true again.
Team Abu Dhabi manager Guido Cappellini could not ask for more than a 1-2 race finish. As the UIM F1H2O flag is passed over to Evian France, see you at Lake Le Mans for round 3.